So good morning everybody. Today we will be going to talk about olefin polymerization catalyst. In the last class we have discussed about olefin and alkyne oligomerization. It is a quite analogous topic and one of the important topic in the industrial prospect, because you know that the olefin, like in particularly ethylene, propylene is the main byproduct of the petrochemical industries. And a huge amount of ethylene and propylene is we always get from the petrochemical industry, which need to be converted into valuable product. So when you convert into ethylene and propylene into polyethylene and polypropylene, which has the different structure, different properties, and it has a very good structure and property relations, it make them that they are one of the most important material in the worldwide. And you can see that about 125 million tons per year this material has been synthesized in every year. It is as per the 2008 data, and it also have the growth rate of like 5% per year, increasing growth rate. You can also see that that makes this olefin polymerization is an important process, and it has been widely used in the initial stage by using the free radical initiator, so mostly like a peroxo species or peroxide species. So in particularly when they use organic peroxides, it need relatively high pressure and high temperatures to get a olefin polymerized product. Then later, the development of organometallic catalysts facilitate the polymerization of olefin at atmospheric condition, that is atmospheric pressure and ambient temperature, which broaden the scope of the olefin polymerization process. So before going to the catalyst aspect of the olefin polymerization, we also talk about briefly about what are the different types of olefin polymerizer product. Although there are numerous numbers are there, but we'll restrict to few important polymeric type. So differentiate the polyolefin, like it can be classified based on the thermoplastic, duroplastic or elastomeric. It has been differentiated with the property. When you talk about thermoplastic, it is a relatively stability under short temperature. There are short strain. That is, when you apply a little bit of strain, it can be stable. And also when you warm it, it has a plastic nature and changes. Whatever the changes occur, it is a reversible. And it is basically built from the linear or slightly branched polymers. So the working temperature is lower than melting point. These are the some of the important properties of thermoplastic polymers. Then duroplastic, it maintains the safe extended period of strain. That means you can apply mechanical strain for a while, and it also it can sustain at high temperature. And it is mostly derived from the cross-linked polymers. So when you apply high temperature and high strain, then what will happen? It's going to happen as irreversible changes. So that's why it's called as a thermosetting materials. So that means when you go beyond certain temperature, it goes to irreversible hardness. So that's why it's called as a the duroplastic materials are like a thermosetting materials. Then elastomeric materials, so they are retain the structures above its glass temperatures, and it can deformation through the application of force. That means when you apply the stress, then it can deform it, and it has a cross linkage of free polymer with the long chain. So it has a long chain cross linkage polymer series, and it return to the starting state with the maximum conformation structure or conformation entropy when you apply the pressure and temperatures. So these are the three major class of polymeric materials which quite often we'll see. Now we'll talk about what are the the catalyst used for this olefin polymerization catalyst process is like one of the well-known catalysts is the Ziegler-Netta catalyst. Here the R is missing. So Ziegler-Netta catalyst, it is one of the organometallic heterogeneous catalysts. It is called as a heterogeneous catalyst. So it is derived by Carl Ziegler and Kleinert. This catalyst used for the preparation of polyolefin. Here the catalyst, basically the catalyst is derived from the combination of early transmetal halides, in particularly titanium chloride, and organometallic compound of main group, mainly ethyl alkyl, trialkyl aluminium species. So when both a combination, then it formed the metal alkyl bond formation with the alkyl aluminium and titanium chloride, and form the intermediate. This is the considered as a catalyst, this organometallic as a catalyst. So it is on the surface of the titanium, so it's a heterogeneous in nature, and you have the vacant side where the olefin is going to coordinate. So this is the basic nature of the catalyst, which is used as a potential catalyst for the olefin polymerization catalyst. Before the development of Jigalanata, there is another catalyst like chromium acetate and silica also used as a catalyst, which that is called as a Phillips process or Phillips polymerization catalyst, that we'll talk about in the later. So these are the in heterogeneous aspect, Phillips polymerization catalyst and Jigalanata catalyst are the two important catalysts which is important. And then other than this heterogeneous catalyst, there are a homogeneous catalyst, or it is called as a single site catalyst, which basically from the zirconium or titanium cyclopentadiene based catalyst. They are all helpful for understanding the mechanism aspect, and also it is also helpful for the preparation of the isostatic polypropylene materials. Then later post metallocene catalysts involve the later transition metal based catalysts, mostly like nickel, iron and palladium based catalysts. They are all highly active, and it is used for co-polymerization of ethylene and polar co-monomers like acetonitrile and other kind of polar co-monomer, and it have the control topologies. It helps to have the control topology. And also there are catalysts used in the free radical initiator and earlier transition metal group like titanium group catalysts, also used for the catalyst for the polymerization, along with the ligand having the phenoxymine. So these are the some of the important catalysts which has been used for the olefin polymerization. Now coming to the polyolefin, so one of the most important and oldest polyolefin which was obtained in industry is the low density polyethylene. So this low density polyethylene has been the oldest polymerized product, as I said. So it has been prepared at high temperature and high pressure. That means it is prepared by with the help of the peroxo or peroxide or oxo peroxo species like a chromium oxo or molybdenum oxo species has been used. So this polyethylene has been prepared by the inter and intramolecular radical transfer, lead to the chain branching with the short branch chain. So the branch chains are short, that result to the poor crystallinity and makes that the material is a low density polyethylene. We can see in the image in the net, so it is just how it will formed. And then next, then what will happen when they use the peroxide radical, it need high pressure and high temperature. So the later Phillips company, that is called as a Phillips polymerization process, they have developed a catalyst that is, as I said, that it is based on the chromium acetate on silica support. So when they use the chromium acetate and silica support, so see, acetate is there, chromium support, silica support have the SiOH bond. So the SiOH bond and OAC, it will interact and forming the chromium will be anchored. You can see that this is how the chromium anchored species we can see the normally. So or we can represent like this. That means the three acetate ligand will be leaving and it will be anchored on the surface through the SiOCr like here. SiOCr, SiOCr, SiOCr. So it is just for representation. Don't worry about these numbers. Okay, don't bother about this number. So this kind of chromium anchored species as the polymerization catalyst. So where the olefin can come and coordinate, and then propagation, chain propagation gives the product and form the olefin, that chromium hydrate species can form. Then subsequently the reaction can continues and can give the polymeric chain can gives. Or the other way we can see that. Chromium having the vacant sites then forming the olefin coordination. This olefin will go to the forming the cyclic product intermediate. Then cyclic intermediate will be the ring cleavage will lead to the propagated olefin propagated chain will form. Then olefin propagated chain will further olefination, or the olefin propagation gives that polymeric process. But at the end there is a beta hydrogen elimination. When the beta hydrate elimination will lead to the termination process, the termination of olefin polymerization occurred by the beta hydrate elimination and gives the alpha olefin and then regeneration of the catalyst. So this is what is called as a high density polyethylene process using the Phillips polymerization catalyst. So Phillips polymerization catalyst is based on the chromium acetate on silica support. Again, this is a heterogeneous catalyst. It works at a pressure range of 10 to 30 bar at relatively low temperature compared to the peroxide species. Then the most important development came by the Jigalanata catalyst. So this is developed by the Carl Ziegler and Giulio Natta in using the titanium chloride and activated trialkyl aluminium, okay, or triethyl aluminium as a combination of these two. So the active species is the formation of the coupled product of titanium chloride and alkyl aluminium and forming the vacant side at titanium center on the surface. Titanium surface is called as a vacant side catalyst. That is a catalyst. So the important aspect of Ziegler-Natta catalyst is they could be able to prepare the polymer having the stereospecific. So that's why they won the Nobel Prize in 1963 for the method on preparation of stereospecific polymer. That is stereospecific polyolefin prepared using the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. Okay, and that properties of this polymer has been depends upon the temperature, molar ratio, as well as functional group present on the monomers. So this depends on that you will get a different types of product have been found. Now the history of Ziegler-Natta catalyst start with when the Ziegler, when he tried to distill the ethyl lithium, when he tried to distill ethyl lithium in presence of ethylene, what he found it, he could able to observe that there is a formation of alpha olefin by the beta hydride elimination of the lithium alkyl. So when the lithium alkyl goes for the beta hydride elimination and they could able to observe the alpha olefins. Then when he obtained the alpha olefin, so he tried to introduce the various intermediate or various co-catalysts like organoaluminium, aluminium and other co-catalysts when he introduced. Then he found that when they introduced organoaluminium particularly, he could see that the polymerization of this olefin occurs at the aluminium center and forming the product like polymers. So when this polymer formed on the aluminium center, when it's go for the dehydroelimination, result the polymeric, that is a polymeric alpha olefin, we get it along with the aluminium hydride species. So this is what he Ziegler has first initially observed using this process. Then he has actually he tried to apply with various kind of co-catalyst. Instead of alkyl aluminium, he introduced a nickel. So when he introduced a nickel, then he found that there is a polymer production was hindered. Then later he unexpectedly he introduced a zirconium acetyl acetonate. So when he introduced a zirconium acetyl acetonate along with the triethyl aluminium, then he found that high yield of polymer product he could able to get it. So then like that he was keep on changing the different types of combination, and he was recognized that the use of titanium chloride and trialkyl aluminium in presence of small amount of magnesium chloride, and he could able to see that the polyolefin using ethylene as a monomer, he could able to get a polyethylene with a molecular weight of 10^4 to 10^-5 at even at room temperature using the 1 bar pressure, he could able to get it. So that is what the Ziegler catalyst first has been processed. And this Ziegler catalyst is called as a Mulheim process for polyethylene production. Mulheim is a German name. It's a Mulheim process of polyethylene production. Then later application of this Ziegler catalyst, that is a titanium chloride and trialkyl, triethyl aluminium catalyst to polymerize the propylene. And what he end up with this, that is by the Giulio-Natta, and he could able to establish the link between the stereochemical structure and bulk properties, and he could able to derive the polymer with the stereospecific property. That's why he got the Giulio-Natta and Ziegler got a Nobel Prize for the preparation of stereospecific structure which he has developed. So and they got a isostatic structure of poly isostatic structure of polypropylene, which has a high density, high tensile strength, so which makes that their material is so interesting. So, as I mentioned in the previous slides, the Ziegler-Natta catalyst development lead to the more structural specificity they could able to get it. That is one of the important development using the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. They could exclusively get the isotactic polypropylene. That is all the methyl group in the polypropylene is aligned in same direction or configured in the same direction with respect to the backbone of the macromolecules. So this is the backbone of the macromolecules. You can see that all the methyl groups align in one direction. So that is what when all the methyl group in a polymer align in the same direction or uniformly aligned, then they called as a isotactic polymers. So use of Ziegler-Natta catalyst, they could be able to exclusively get this kind of product, and it has a unique property, structural property and stability. So that is what they won the Nobel Prize. The same way, when the polypropylene forming, when there is a regular change of methyl group orientation or methyl group configuration along the backbone, then it is called as a synteotic. So you can see that the methyl group in this direction, the other methyl group is in the opposite direction. Again, this opposite direction, alternative methyl groups are in the opposite direction. Then they called as a, those kind of polymers are called as a synteotic polypropylene. And where the methyl groups are randomly arranged or irregularly arranged along the backbone of the macromolecule or polymeric macro chain backbone, then it is called as a atactic polymers or atactic propylene. So the use of Ziegler-Natta catalyst, they could be able to exclusively get a isotactic polymers that has a unique properties, structural and material properties, that makes that material is so interesting, and that lead to the Ziegler-Natta to get a Nobel Prize. Okay, so now mechanism aspect of the catalyst. As I mentioned, titanium chloride is used as a catalyst which alkylated on the surface and act as an active species. The alkylation has been proceeded via the presence of magnesium chloride using the triethyl or triethyl aluminium species. So the magnesium chloride act as an intermediate, and this is a tetraethyl titanium, and in presence of triethyl aluminium, it formed the octaethyl intermediate with the vacant sites at the, one of the vacant sites is going to create it on the metal surface. So this is the heterogeneous nature and organometallic heterogeneous natures and creating the vacant sites. This vacant site, the olefin is going to coordinate it. So once olefin is coordinated, then subsequently the next step will be the olefin is going to have the migratory insertion between the metal carbon, that is titanium carbon bond. So this insertion is, the insertion of olefin into the titanium carbon bond is similar to the carbonyl insertion on the metal carbon bond. So this is sort of agostic interaction. Because of the agostic interaction, it is going to insert on the metal centers and forming the what is called as isotactic polymeric beginning. It's forming the polymeric species. Then subsequently, the propagation of the chain is going to happen by introduction of additional olefin. So you will get a isotactic polymeric chain has been propagating is occur. So once the chain transfer is continuous, at the end there will be a beta hydrate elimination. So when there is a beta hydrate elimination, you will get a isotactic polypropylene as the product, you will get it. So this is the proposed mechanism based on the Ziegler-Natta catalyst. This mechanism has been supported with the organometallic homogeneous catalyst. So this mechanism basically supported with the help of the organometallic catalyst, that is a homogeneous catalyst, that is a zirconosine halide and methyl alumoxane. This analogous to Ziegler-Natta catalyst, giving the isotactic structure of the polypropylene. So that homogeneous catalyst helped to understand the mechanism aspect of the heterogeneous catalyst. Whatever proposed is the, it's a well matching or well suitable for the proposed mechanism. So they have chosen that the zirconosine catalyst is like is cyclopentadienyl, dicyclopentadienyl zirconium dichloride, which is react with the methyl aluminium oxide, that is what methyl alumoxane, and forming the intermediate is like a dicyclopentadienyl methyl cationic species, zirconium cationic species, and then methyl aluminium oxides is the anionic species. So this is what the active catalyst. So in this active catalyst, the olefin is going to coordinate, and then subsequently chain propagation is going to occur by the metal, the olefin insertion between the metal carbon bond, and then reaction is going to proceed for the polymerization. So once the polymerization is continued, then you will end up with this in the case of ethylene, here in the case of propylene, I will get a polymerization is continue, and you will get a polypropylene or polyethylene product will get it. At the end, there will be beta hydrate elimination lead to the product. Once again, this catalyst also gives the isotactic polypropylene, which support that the formation of isostatic polypropylene using this catalyst support that the mechanism of Ziegler-Natta catalysis as proposed earlier. So the mechanism of Ziegler-Natta catalyst was confirmed with the help of this catalyst. So that's why this catalyst is more important. So these are the aspect about the polymers, olefin polymerization. We'll talk about it. Here we stop here. So we covered olefin polymerization already. So now in the next class, we'll be talking about the Fischer-Tropsch process and water gas shift reactions, by which we most probably will be completing all the organometallic catalyst portion. Then we'll be moving on to the bio-inorganic. So before going to bio-inorganic, we will have the exam, online exam, internal, as well as I will ask for the online Viva in this, so far whatever the chapter we covered, through the one-to-one interaction. So all of you go through regularly. Thank you very much.